this big gigantic couch and every subscriber is sitting on it and we're just like watching TV together and hanging out, and I want that to feel this way. Hey buddy. What's up? Back in the magic seat, the big comfy couch. I look dark. Oh, I look fluffy too. So for those of you that weren't in my live stream, I'll get you some light here in a second. Bear with me. I did a 3.5 hour live stream because I went to Greece during comeback. I missed everything. Came back to the whirlwind. We did the live stream, knocked out the dinner, discussed all that. But now this is my chance to get caught up with the comeback stuff. And I'm probably going to mess up the order of stuff, but it's fine. I want to see what's going on. Let's see if I can give you some light here. Cool. Too much. Okay. That's better. Oh, bright little face. It's like that. Sugar has the pterodactyl drop him off and just watch his little butt walk away. All right. So today we have the proof of inspiration for all the members. Somebody compiled these. I have seen, I think I watched two of them when they first dropped, but that was like 3 weeks ago, like a month ago, maybe. So I couldn't tell you what was said. And now there's this level of awareness, you know? Am I gonna view this differently now that the dinner has happened and they've announced what they've announced? So, I'm curious to see how this goes, I guess. Let's get into it, shall we?
저는 이번 엔솔로즈 앨범 프루프에 페르소나와 스테이가 들어가면 좋겠다고 생각을 했습니다. 왜냐면 페르소나라는 노래가 이제 나는 누구인가로 시작을 하잖아요. 그래서 데뷔부터 지금까지 달려오면서 그런 생각을 아무래도 지금도 그렇고 뭐 많이 하게 된 것 같아요. 또 나라는 페르소나 안에 뭐 인간 김남준도 있고 가족 친구로서의 김남준도 있고 그냥 음악을 만드는 RM도 있고 자아들이 굉장히 많아지다 보니까 좀 부담이 많이 되고 뭐가 진짜 난가 싶기도 하고 그랬는데 결국 제가 고민하는 그 모습들이 전부 제 자신이더라고요. 그럼에도 제가 누군지에 관계없이 항상 제 옆에 스테이 해준 제 멤버들 또 아미 여러분들이 제 프루프가 아닌가 그렇게 생각을 합니다.
저는 이번
오케이 Already If this Okay Oh, man. Already I can tell you, I'm looking at this through post-dinner eyes. And some of you are realizing the exact same thing right now, because maybe you're in the same boat as me. Like, I saw Junie's proof drop. I watched it when it first launched, before a comeback. Now, what he's saying post-dinner, it hits completely differently. Everything he's saying about the real me and how there's different versions of himself, and he struggles, but he wonders, like, which one's the real me? And he's trying to articulate that. And then what he said in the, totally different. Oh, man. This is going to be interesting. Even if I can't articulate why or how I find this interesting, looking at this all through post-dinner eyes, I guess, which is going to be a thing now, it's going to feel interesting. I don't know where this is going to go. I might have to go back through this a second time. You with me? We doing this together? All right. Now we got Jin.
앨범에 문과 잠의 뷰를 수록해서 다시 한번 여러분께 들려드리고 싶었어요.
저랑 아미가 지구와 달처럼 떼려고 해도 뗄 수 없는 관계라는 건 이제 모두가 인정하는 사실이잖아요. 문을 그런 의미로 만들었다는 건 이미 너무 잘 알려진 사실이고 이젠 제가 아미이고 아미가 저인 거의 동화된 단계에 온 것 같습니다. 결국 제가 걸어왔던 시간들이 결국에는 아미 여러분들이 없이는 있을 수 없던 거죠. 여러분들이 저 그리고 저희 방탄소년단의 산증인 프로프가 아닌가 싶습니다. 자매뷰의 가사처럼 제가 지치고 힘들 때마다 항상 저에게 치유 안식처가 되어준 멤버들과 아미 여러분들을 생각하면서 앞으로도 더 좋은 음악 들려드리도록 하겠습니다.
See again. And maybe it's not as crazy as I think it is. Maybe this is like a confirmation bias thing where I'm looking at everything specifically through the aperture of the dinner and the announcement. And I'm just finding little pieces that match up with what I think is going on. I don't know. But I can't deny, and I'm not justifying what I just said. I'm just saying, like, I think that, like, Jin talking about being exhausted, right? And how, like, the music and the members have been this refuge. Yeah, it's hard not to see that. Yeah, I definitely got to go through this again. Now, I think I may have listened to Moon, maybe, in one of the live streams. And you know, if you have been in any of the live streams that I've done, it's kind of just like a party. Like, I have no plan most of the time. I mean, aside from like album listens where I'm like, hey, let's start with this album. And then I put on that album, we listen to it. Most of the time, I'm not getting into the lyrics or the music videos. Most of the time, I'm not really interpreting anything. We're just listening to music and hanging out. That's pretty much what's happening. So if I listen to a song on a live stream, I'm not getting into the weeds. Like, I'm not black swanning that thing. For those of you that survived my black swan reaction video, which I think was like an hour and a half and just madness, it's not that. I put on a song, I kind of let it wash over me, I feel it. I might look at the lyrics briefly, but I'm not deep diving it, which is why I always say in my live streams, if I listen to a song on the live, know that I will always go back and it will have its own deep dive video. And that's the reason I say that is because Moon, I know, is a huge song for Jin. It's a really important song for a lot of people, which is probably why he chose it to be one of the ones that went on Proof. But I can't remember if I even heard it. And the reason for that is because I didn't deep dive it. The ones that I have deep dived. I know those songs. I know those songs because I got lost in them. So I definitely got to go and hit Moon for a deep dive. Have to.
저는 가장 대조되는
I still haven't heard the Suga whisper. You guys keep telling me that before most of Suga's verses that he raps, he whispers Suga. Something like that. I haven't heard that yet. I need to check that out.
느낌을 지닌 두 곡을 골라봤습니다. 비교적 잔잔한 시소와 상대적으로 더 세고 에너지가 터지는 킬러인데요. 뭔가 이런 양극단의 노래 스타일들 사이에 또 어떤 곡을 만들 수 있을까? 그런 제 음악 스펙트럼을 넓혀가는 고민들을 하는 게 저에게는 재미있고 의미 있는 시간들인 것 같습니다. 음악적 스펙트럼에 한계를 두지 않고 새로운 도전을 하는 게 저 그리고 방탄소년단의 정체성이 아닌가 싶고요. 그런 고민들과 생각들이 만들어낸 저 그리고 방탄소년단의 모든 음악이 저희의 프로프가 아닐까요?
I'm so not surprised that that's how Suga's Proof went. Not at all. more and more and more that I pay attention to Yoongi, I see that he he lives and breathes musicality. If that makes sense. I feel like musically he's just on a whole different level. And I don't mean like ability wise. I mean drive wise, like I don't know, attention is not the right word, but you can tell. Like there's almost, and this is not like for Yoongi, there's less emotion in this than the others, I think. And more like his passion is the music and his abilities with the music. It's his art. He lives and breathes the music and what he's capable of. And he's talking about no limits. This doesn't surprise me one bit. And the fact that he goes so deep as to say, when I chose my songs, it was about the contrasting, the polarity between those two. That is not an emotional response. That is a very calculated decision made from the fact that he's trying to push himself as far across that musical spectrum as he can, within, you know, like outside of his abilities and reaching and pushing and trying different genres. That is Yoongi. And that is exactly what I expected. And I think that right there is confirmed, there's my confirmation bias again, by what he said in the dinner. Because like, yeah, he had his moments where he kind of, you know, had to clamp down emotionally. But he talked about feeling free, that he could freely experience the music again, that he didn't feel like he had to squeeze out content. He needed to feel something. And once he felt free again, he was able to do the music his way that he wanted to. Like, he wanted to be able to drive that train. And I think this is on par with that.
저는 이번 앨범 Proof의 Her 이 곡 이렇게 넣어봤습니다. 허가 사랑 노래이긴 한데 몇몇 아미분들이 가사를 보면 또 억지로 상대에게 맞추는 것에 대해
Some army interpreted the lyrics as being more complex. That doesn't sound like us at all.
힘들어하는 것처럼 보이는 좀 그런 고차원적인 곡이다라고 해석을 하시더라고요. 다양한 해석이 가능하겠지만 가끔 보여주기 싫은 내 모습을 감추기 위해서 가식적인 모습을 보여줘야 되는 때도 있었어요. 그런 모습을 보여주기 싫어서 숨겼을 때도 있었고
Let me apologize. I think that also you're probably not having an easy time reading those captions at all because of the color and the size. I don't know, maybe. And if it's difficult, I'm sorry. But I don't know if there's much I can do about it.
하지만 저는
Let me go back a little bit.
그런 모습을 보여주기 싫어서 숨겼을 때도 있었고 하지만 저는 오히려 그 보여주기 싫은 모습까지도 나다 나의 그런 모습까지 있는 그대로 받아들여주는 멤버들과 아미 여러분들이 있다고 생각하니까 그걸 모두 제 자아, 이고의 한 부분으로 받아들이게 되더라고요 지금 있는 그대로의 제 모습, 제 이고가 저의 proof인 것 같습니다
First of all The first thing I'm going to say, the second thing I'm going to say talks about identity. The first thing I'm going to say is about this right here.
고차원적인 곡이다라고 해석을 하시더라고요. 다양한 해석...
There can be many different interpretations, talking about of the song, Her.
해석이 가능하겠지만, 가끔 보여...
But there are times when I have to wear a mask to hide the sides of myself.
내 모습을 감추기 위해서...
That I don't particularly want to show other people. Okay. I don't necessarily think, and I'm not going to say something that's going to, this is not shocking when I say this. That's not exclusive to idols, or celebrities. Obviously, we know that. That's something that every single one of us on some level, at some point, can relate to. And I think... One way that I have struggled in that regard, and maybe you can relate to this, is that You even go so far as to wonder if you acting a certain way at work versus family versus friends is also some form of mask that you need to evaluate and dig into. Like, is there something deeper going? I don't know. Maybe that's just me. But I know that that is something that I have wondered, because I'm constantly going through the runaround with, like, how can I be better? What am I messing up? You know, that's a whole different video. But you see what I mean? The masks, I think, is a really relatable concept. I think there's a self-preservation to that. I think it's a matter of protecting ourselves, you know, from rejection and all kinds of stuff. But the other piece that I'll mention is identity. The running theme here, like, these are called proof of inspiration. So they do talk about what inspired them to choose the songs that they chose. But you notice the running theme through all of this so far is their identity. Was this a very clever way of adding subtext into this comeback to kind of ease people into the fact of the announcement is coming? Is that a possibility? Love to hear your thoughts on that. Or is what we're seeing, is that fact that that theme exists so far, is that a symptom or a result of what we know to be true post-dinner? Right? Yeah, I don't know if that made sense when I said it, but without really getting cattywampus, that's a word, I think I'll just leave that there and move on. But I don't know, maybe, yeah, coffee.
모습을 보여줘야 되는 때도 있었어요. 그런 모습을 보여주기 싫어서 숨겼을 때도 있었고, 하지만 저는 오히려 그 보여주기 싫은 모습까지도 나다. 나의 그런 모습까지 있는 그대로 받아들여주는 멤버들과 아미 여러분들이 있다고 생각하니까 그걸 모두 제 자아, 이고의 한 부분으로 받아들이게 되더라고요. 지금 있는 그대로의 제 모습, 제 이고가 저의 프루프인 것 같습니다.
Who I am just as I am. I am suddenly reminded of the song from The Greatest Showman called This Is Me. It's probably one of the most powerful songs ever written, in my opinion. And that's probably, I feel that way because it speaks to me. But when Hobie talks about this is who I am, just like just as I am, and I've accepted all sides of myself, that's, yeah, that's kind of what speaks to me.
제가 이번 앨범에 수록을 원했던 곡은 필터와 친구였어요.
Immediately, filter. Come on, think about the lyrics of filter. Think about the point. Immediately, right to identity. You might not feel the same way, but my mind is blowing right now. You can't see it because it's like, you know, you didn't watch the headphones go. But yeah, like, there's a whole bunch of connections being made for me right now. And most of you have probably already gone through this. Like, you went through it. As soon as the dinner happened, you went, oh yeah, the proofs. And you connected all the pieces. I don't know. You connected the dots. But for me, and the way that I did it, watching the dinner first, and now watching these, totally different perspective than I would have had given the reverse. I wanted to live up to ARMY's expectations. Show the many different sides to myself.
Ooh.
I don't want to... Interpretation can be really difficult and really tricky because I don't want to put words in Jimin's mouth. But something just hit me. I still have many different colors left to share. I might have come across as being colorless instead of colorful. Where did that come from? Oh wait. If I'd have accommodated myself to other people's ideas, without having a distinct hue of my own. Okay. See, context. Context makes all the difference. Look at that. I got the whole sentence and then it made sense instead of me just drawing my own conclusions piece by piece. But what I wanted to say, and even with the context, this makes sense. I still have many different colors left to share. Given the discussion, given the announcement discussion, there's one thing that's popped in my head and I can't stop thinking about it since the dinner. I feel like, I wonder if there is a fear. Like from a celebrity standpoint, and I'm not just talking BTS, but think about any celebrity. Over the years, over your lifetime, this concept should sound familiar and believable. You ready for this? As a celebrity, and I again, celebrity is a very loose term, in someone in the public eye, whatever you want that to mean, when you seemingly have nothing left to give, they turn their back on you. I don't know if there's much more to say to that. I mean, because it makes, like from an entertainer standpoint, the audience exists because you provide. You provide entertainment. The audience is there for that entertainment. So if you have nothing left to contribute, there's no reason for them to watch. So the audience disappearing when you have nothing left to contribute makes sense. And I say all that because I wonder, for the seven of them, has the fear ever existed? I still have many different colors left to share. Is there a possibility somewhere that there is a fear that essentially says, I'm worried that I'm not going to reach your expectations and you're going to turn your back on me? Is that possible? My opinion, and that's why I'm saying it, that's why I'm saying all this, because I think that's absolutely the case. I have felt that from my standpoint doing this little stuff that I'm doing. This stuff doesn't even hold a candle to what BTS is doing, obviously. But I have felt that way, and I've expressed that. I've talked to you all openly and honestly and directly, and I have been incredibly vulnerable on camera. And I've told you, like, I worry. I enjoy this so much that I am consistently, regularly worried about what's gonna happen when this ends. I worry about that because I enjoy it so much. The amount of equity that even just the concept and notion of ARMY has inside each member of BTS. Think about that. If you were a member of BTS yourself, having taken the journey for the last 10, 12 years that you've taken, and the amount of work that you have put in, the amount of hours and seconds and years that you have been on camera, think about how heavy that's going to weigh on you and how much you're going to worry that at some point they could all turn and walk away. That has to exist, right? See, and that's why for me, the dinner was so hard. And a lot of you have expressed this. Again, I'm not saying anything that's really out in left field, I don't think, because a lot of you have said, like, you agree with what I said. It was hard to hear. And plus, I know there were translation issues. I know there was a whole uproar. The media did what the media do. I got it. The fears happened. The whirlwind took place. But then things calmed down. And we all, not all, but a lot of people said, now that that's over with, I can say I really want them to be happy. And I feel, in a way, guilty that we may have had something to do with the pressure that they feel or they have felt. You know, it's so complex. It's so complicated. Wow, that one line, and I still have many different colors left to share. That just sparked a whole tirade. Shall we continue?
많은 색깔들이 남아있기도 하고요. 그런데 이제 딱 저만의 색깔 없이 다른 사람들 생각에만 맞추면 다채로워 보이지 않고 오히려 색이 없어 보였을 것 같은데 항상 제 본질이 무엇인지 생각할 수 있게 해주고 딱 중심을 잡도록 해준 게 바로 저의 친구, 멤버들과 아미 여러분들이었던 것 같아요. 여러분들이 저의 프루프입니다.
Can I just take a moment?
이었던 것 같아요. 여러분들이 저의 프로프.
What an adorable picture. Seriously. I had to say that. That is adorable.
빈다.
이번 앨범.
All right, so what do we got? Now we got V. Singularity and 0 o'clock. Man, right there, screaming at you. Screaming at you front and center. 0 o'clock. Reset.
프로프의 싱귤러리티 그리고 제로 클락 이런
Singularity. Come on. You seeing this? Are you seeing this?
이렇게 두 곡을 선택해 보았는데요. 싱귤러리티 뮤직비디오에서 비주얼적으로
An identity. I tended to think of Kim Taehyung as artist and artist V as being separate.
표현했던 것처럼 김태형이라는 사람과 V라는 아티스트 이 두 자아 사이에서 하나를 선택해야 하는 그런 분리된 생각을 많이 했었던 것 같은데요.
No way, that was such a great video, and that song is so sexy. The way that he visually portrayed that in the video, the identity, oh yeah.
이때 진짜 제가 어떤 사람인지 고민도 많이 들고 혼란스러웠던 시기였었던 것 같아요.
Man, I can't, this, it's blowing my mind, seriously. I fully acknowledge that most of you have already been through this, now you're just watching me go through it. But this tying in with what was said about, you know, like V struggling with who he is as a person, who he is as an artist. I'm thinking about who I am as a person and I feel confused because they don't have time to grow. Right? They haven't been allowed that. They've been stuck in this box that is the industry and all. Okay.
아티스트 비로소 무대를 즐기고 아미 여러분들과 무대도 하고 또 한편으로는 인간 김태형으로서 가족과 친구들과 일상생활을 즐기고 하다 보니까 지금은 두 자아를 잘 받아들이고 나눠서 생.
I think that's so brilliant. Ordinary days as Tay. But V performs on stage for the masses. Now I'm able to accept both sides of myself, but also keep them separate. You talk about self-preservation, especially on the scale of BTS, that international level of fame. Man, I don't know how you could survive it without doing that. And oh man.
생각할 수 있게 된 것 같습니다. 자정이 되면 하루가 리셋되는 것처럼
고민들도 좀 없어졌고요. 오히려 그런 고민들이 다 지금의 저를 만든 저의 프로프가 아니었나 wow. 생각합니다.
Made me into who I am today.
네, 저는 이번 앨범에 유포리아랑 보조개를 넣어봤습니다. 그냥 솔직히 그냥 어떤 노래를 하던 그냥 형들이랑 같이 노래하고 아미 여러분들이랑 함께 호흡할 때가 제일 좋은 것 같아요. 사실 이게 제가 꿈꿔왔던 일이잖아요. 저는 지금도 노래하고 춤을 추는 그때가 너무 좋고 공연을 하면서 듣는 함성 소리에 너무 행복하고요. 무대 있을 때가 가장 행복한 것 같고 그런 저를 보면서 같이 행복해하는 사람들이 있어서 좋고 매일매일이 감사하고 또 즐길 수 있는 시간들인 것 같습니다. 아미 여러분을 보면서 행복하게 웃으면서 음악을 하는 제 모습 그리고 제 모습을 보면서 덩달아 웃게 되는 여러분들의 미소가 바로 제 프로프인 것 같습니다.
Man, that couldn't have been more direct and concise and to the point of JK saying, I love what I do. I love being up here. Now, he didn't go so far as to say, and I will continue. No, we know he's going to. Man, that was all of them. That's fascinating to me. I got it. Ooh. Wow. I wonder if I can maybe just in case it didn't work with the captions and all that, if there's a way auto-translate, that's going to be terrible. No, I'll just leave it alone. What are we at, 32 minutes? Maybe I shouldn't go through it again. See, this is so difficult because I'm... Like, am I looking too deep into it? Like, tell me, you know, if I'm looking too hard through the post-dinner aperture, tell me what you think. I'd be really curious to hear what you have to say. You know, as I've said before, in probably videos and live streams and stuff, like I'm the kind of guy, like I need as much information as I can get from as many different walks and types. And, you know, I talk to my friends, like I have friends that I trust, and I'll kind of give you my situation. Hey, kind of here's where I'm at. Like, you know, help me process through this. And I get their 2 cents, and then I get their 2 cents, and then their 2 cents. And then I use that information to kind of, as Jimin said, center myself. You know, a lot of times it takes me a while to respond in a discussion or an argument or whatever, because everything that I'm trying to say has to go through this filter of like empathy, logic. You know, like I don't want to just shoot out some emotional response that could like hurt somebody or you know cause some kind of damage that's not fixable. You know, I'm not saying right, but yeah, I'd be curious to hear what you have to say. Looking through all the proofs of inspiration, but now through the lens that I have, which is post-dinner and post-dinner only, let me know what you think. Like, does it line up? Does it really line up? Or is this just full confirmation bias and I'm looking too deep into it? Am I black swanning the proofs of inspiration? Yeah, I'm going to have to chew on this one. But I really can't wait to hear what you have to say. I'm Roscoe, you BTS buddy. I haven't said this in a long time. Look out for each other. We still have a long, long journey ahead of us.